I'm a Virgo, September 10th, 1940. And it feels good to be here, you know. I'm very happy to say that I have more sample hits than anyone. That is sample hits. I think James Brown holds the record for more samples, but I have more sample hits than anyone. And I'm very proud of that, you know. It makes me really feel good. It lets me know that a lot of young artists, or at least the hip-hop artists, are really listening to my music and saying, wow, I should sample that. I asked one of them, I said, why do you like my music so much? He said, because of the sound. When I recorded music, a lot of music was recorded with the analog sound, and not necessarily the digital sound, but the analog sound is a much better sound. And of course, I still use it. I like what Mary J. Blige did on Everybody Loves the Sunshine. She did a song called My Life. Very nice. I also like A Tribe Called Quest and Brand Nubian. Oh, so many people, Ed O.G. and the Bulldogs, so many people that have sampled my music, it's incredible. Well, there are many. There's a young vibist named Harris, Stephon Harris. He sounds very good. He kind of reminds me of me when I was a lot younger. I like the trumpeter, Roy Hargrove. Roy plays nice trumpet. He reminds me of Miles Davis when Miles was a young man. I like not only just the jazz artists, but I like Alicia Keys. She's fantastic. She's asked me to do a couple of shows with her. As a matter of fact, she sent me these flowers. She's a fan of Roy Ayers. I said, wow. I like her style too, because she's different, original, and unique. Well, the process is interesting. When I was asked by the president of the record company that I was with, he said, Roy, can you do a soundtrack album? I said, of course. Of course, when I said, of course, I had never done a soundtrack album in my life. And he said, well, the people at American International Pictures would like for you to come out there and do a soundtrack for a movie called Coffee, which starred Pam Grier. And I said, let's go for it. You know, they flew me out to California, and I went over the scripts. I saw the moviola. I learned about it at the same time, and it was very simple to do. And I got a film out of it. Brooklyn is a great city. I love going to Brooklyn. I record out there at a studio. Of course, Brooklyn means a lot to me as far as the composition called We Live in Brooklyn, Baby. That was written by a pianist named Harry Whitaker, and he said, Roy, what do you think about this? And he played it for me. I said, I like that. And then we did it. And I said,
we live in Brooklyn, baby. We live in Brooklyn, baby.
I love that song. This apartment belonged to James Baldwin. James's room was right two doors back. In conversations that I had with James, he was a good listener. He was patient. And he would sometimes intersect and say, have you ever thought about this like that? Interesting man. Extremely well-read person, a very warm person, a very positive person. And it's a shame that a lot of people, especially young people, they don't know who he is or who he was. You know, James walked and marched with Dr. Martin Luther King. Even Malcolm X said, the press, they don't want to talk to James Baldwin because James is going to tell it like it is. That's what Malcolm X said. It was a wonderful experience to have known him and to be able to sit in the same room with he and his brother, David.
He's a superstar, yeah.
As I go through life, I reflect on some of the most wonderful people that I've had experiences with in conversation, and just listening to them speak and seeing what they think and feel. Just to have those moments. Wow, the time passes so fast. You know, when you start thinking, you say, wow, time's going by quick.
Nobody gets a picture of this room. You got a picture of, my God, special room, girl.